Now to something that will make you feel really, really old. Move over, millennials. There's actually a new generation in town. They're called Generation Alpha.
No older than age 10. They are the first generation entirely born within the 21st century. They're children who haven't known a world without technology and devices. And just to put it into perspective, Instagram was introduced the year they were born. Oh, yeah.
How old do you feel?
We feel very old. To tell us how old we feel, Generation Alpha, we're joined by demographer Mark McCrindle. Good to see you again, Mark. Okay, so Generation Alpha, explain.
They're the children of the Gen Ys that we know well in their 20s and 30s. So this is the next generation of youngster born since 2010. So they're now starting school. There's already 3 million of them in Australia, so it's not a new generation in that sense. But clearly this technology, the device, smartphones, that's only what they've ever known. Mm. Smart speakers that speak back to you, you know, the video games of today, and autonomous driverless trains like we've got in Sydney now. So it's all happened just in their generation.
Yeah. Yeah, and you definitely know that they are that because they're the only generation that actually will say to you, well, Google it, you know, like back right. to you, like it's just so different. How do you think these guys compare to other generations?
Well, they'll be larger because we've got more population than ever and more births than ever. They'll live longer as well. Clearly, they're the most culturally diverse generation and globally connected, you know, through their technology. Mm. So that'll be the lens they bring. Yeah. You know, digital, social, global, mobile in terms of where they'll study and work and travel, multiple career. So a lot of changes for them ahead.
You've done a great diagram that you've given to us here, which is available on your website, Mark. It's quite interesting because in the iconic toys section, there's roller skates, frisbee, Rubik's Cube, BMX bike, folding scooter, and this generation over has a fidget spinner. Gee, they don't get out much, do they?
No. Indoor generation.
We're lucky to find something that wasn't digital. You know, everything else is on the device. So it's pretty hard to get them away from those devices. And a lot of educators and forecasters are saying, you know, we're into a global experiment. Yeah. They were given these devices. The iPad was born in their lifetime, and smartphones the year they were born. They've had these things from before they could talk. So what impacts is it going to have? I mean, certainly for positive, but some challenges as well.
Yeah, so true. By 2030, Generation Alpha is going to make up 11% of the workforce. So what kind of jobs will they have?
Well, we're seeing massive changes to the workforce. The jobs that we used to know are disappearing, new ones emerging, cybersecurity and app developer and cryptocurrency, you know. So I think the future is going to hold, to be future-proof for them, a lot of change. They'll have to be lifelong learners. There won't be career for life anymore. Mm. They'll have to be adaptive and watch where careers are going and upskill and retrain to remain relevant.
Bit of criticism around the current millennials and the Gen Ys for often staying at home with their parents longer than they should. So does that mean financially that the alphas might be a little bit more independent?
Well, we're still going to see those house prices, you know, continue ahead, and they are going to stay longer in education before they start earning. So that's going to put them behind financially a bit. But, you know, they're going to have to live longer. They're going to have longer in retirement. So it's just that they're taking their working years and shifting it back a little as they invest earlier on in education. So they probably will be at home little later like their parents.
And probably live longer too with the advances in medicine and technology, you'd imagine also.
And I think that longevity boom is massive. You know, we hear about the ageing population, and that's because people are living longer. So they will work later in life, and they'll move through more life stages than we've defined in the 20th century.
Will they be wealthier?
Yeah, they will, because they'll have longer in retirement, you know, or they'll work longer before retirement. And retirement won't be getting out of work. It'll be downshifting and still keeping a little bit active in the earnings years. But working through their 60s, well into their 70s, will become the norm.
Yeah, is it scary for Generation Alpha? I mean, should we as parents be worried about anything that they face in their future?
Well, I think we need to give a bit of confidence to them. You know, if we look at young people and the insecurities they face, the mental health issues, I think it's because we're painting a picture of an uncertain future, but we've got to give them confidence that actually, if you invest in your future, if you get some good training, if you've got life skills and people skills, you'll be relevant forever. Yeah. Robots won't take over, and that'll give them the confidence to move forward.
And what about grandparents as well? What's your advice to staying connected to the new alpha generation for those people?
Well, I think grandparents play such a role now. You know, we're talking about the baby boomers who've got that life experience, and they'll be able to instill that. They'll take on a bit of that caring role because the parents, the Gen Ys, will be out working so much. Mm. So I think the role of grandparents has stepped up in our society.
Yeah, I'll take on a bit of a caring role.
It's all about talking about the children still being at home. Living longer and wealthier. I was like, oh.
Jeez. All right, Mark, always great to chat to you. Fascinating stuff. Oh, Generation Alpha is here. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Hopefully, we'll be back with more in just a moment.